Dears, next lipid soluble vitamin is D. So A we finished. So next one we are going to study about vitamin D. See, first of all, they will ask you what is a precursor of vitamin D. From where vitamin D comes? It comes from cholesterol. So synthesizing of vitamin D from cholesterol. We'll study in the chapter metabolism of cholesterol. There is a rate limiting enzyme, very important step or enzyme. That is rate. What is the enzyme? 1-alpha-hydroxylase. It's an direct MCQ. 1-alpha-hydroxylase. So keep in mind this. 1-alpha-hydroxylase has been forming what? Vitamin D from cholesterol. I told you vitamin D is also having different forms. One is calciferol. Second is ergocalciferol. Third one is cholcalciferol. See, this ergocalciferol is called vitamin D2 and this is vitamin D3. Now ergocalciferol, they are obtained from plants. And this comes from animals, vitamin D3 or cholcalciferol, keep in mind that. So whenever sunlight reaches, react with the cholesterol, they will form vitamin D. Deficiency of vitamin D, deficiency, they causes softening of bone, that is called osteomalacia in adults, and rickets in children. Right? So osteomalacia in adults and rickets in children is caused by what? Deficiency of vitamin D. Now, again, the richest source of vitamin D. So richest source is again our halibut oil. That is again tapish oil, that is halibut, tapish. So richest source is again halibut, keep in mind that. Now the RDA, recommended daily allow, amount of the vitamin D you need daily. Okay, so it include for a adult, he need 5 microgram per day. For a child, 10 microgram per day, and if for a pregnant woman, 10 microgram per day. So these are the important steps you have to remember about vitamin D, asked in many important MCQ exam. Did I miss something? No. Okay. So I think I have given everything. See, there is one more thing. Deficiency of vitamin D. They can trigger, deficiency can trigger breast cancer, colon cancer, and prostate cancer. So that's all about vitamin D. So these are the important things you have to remember about vitamin D. Clear? Now we'll move to the vitamin E and K, the last two.